probably figured, I chose to investigate backyard wrestling as my topic for English media. The reason I chose to do it was simply because I participated anyways and thought it'd be easy to do. I wrestle in a backyard league in Port Alvin called HCW for hardcore wrestling. Recently, HCW has made a number of accomplishments not too many people are aware of. Today, I'm going to tell you a bit about our group and show you a few clips so you don't die from boredom. Anyways, here are the other wrestlers that will be featured on today's video.
Anyways, many people have asked us, you know, why we hurt ourselves and spend time on this hobby when we don't really get anything from it. The reason is, it provides entertainment for us and anyone who comes to watch us.
From 1997 to 2000, HCW moved from the indoors
to the trampoline.
And finally, to the ground. During HCW's duration of 5 years, we have always brought in inanimate weapons to the delight of our hardcore fans.
By far, the board has been the most popular weapon in HCW.
Others, including tacks, fire, barbed wire, and ironing boards. In fall of 2002, HCW wrestled for something new, our 15 minutes of fame. Well, as corny that may sound, we finally believed we were good enough to put our efforts towards something that would give us recognition from our local community.
We first started renting and signing our tapes at Justin Releases in Port Elgin. That went on for about a couple of months. And although our 35-minute tape rented out about 25 times, a couple of do-gooders complained about the video because it had too much violence. Speaking of violence, here are some more clips that I'm sure you will all enjoy.
back to where we left off. In the winter of 2002, we sent the tape down to Los Angeles, California, to a company that produces videos showcasing the best of backyard wrestling around the globe. Sure enough, in the first week of March, we received this document, among many others, stating that HCW had indeed made the cut and would be appearing in their upcoming videos, volumes 5 and 6.
New videos have not yet been released. HCW could be featured on a nationally distributed video in the near future.
Recently, in the month of May, both Chaos and Kadabra of HCW were both signed to appear on the Rude Jude Show, a sidekick of the Jenny Jones, on the topic of backyard wrestling in Chicago.
Furthermore, Kadabra and I also went to Newark, New Jersey recently to train at East Coast Professional Wrestling for one day, and man, did we ever get our asses kicked.
As promised, we'll take you through a making of a typical event.
With all our weapon needs, we need to get it somewhere.
Yep, that's right. The dump.
What we do next is quite simple. First, we get a truck to meet us at the dump.
We then load whatever we manage to find into the truck.
We then drive the truck back to Mark's house until it can be used for the upcoming event.
The first thing we need to do is set up the mats and take out any materials that we need to use. We then put the final touches to the setup by taking out chairs for our countless diehard fans and other things like the entrance and CD.
Spots with our opponent who are wrestling that day.
As promised earlier in the video, we will show you the results of our latest event in a music video entitled HCW Blade.
We call this event Blade in memory of our late friend Eric Coglin, who wrestled under the name Blade in HCW just a few short years ago.
Starting to rain.
I know. Oh!
least. HCW.
Fuck it.
Although the volume's Although the volumes have not yet been released, HCW could be featured on an
Man.
Although HCW
Man, just
Although the new volumes have not yet been released, HCW could be featured on a nationally distributed video.
Man.
New videos have not yet been released. HCW could be featured on a nationally distributed video in the near future.
Recently, in the month of May, both Chaos and Kadabra of Recently, in the month of May, both Chaos and Kadabra of HCW were both signed to appear on the Rude Jude Show as sidekick up to Jenny Jones on the topic of backyard wrestling in Chicago.
Furthermore, Kadabra and I also went to Newark, New Jersey recently to train at East Coast Professional Wrestling for one day, and man, did we ever get our asses kicked.
What we do next is quite simple. First, we get a truck to meet us at the dump.
We then load anything we can manage to find into the trunk.
Thanks, Debbie.
We then load whatever we manage to find into the truck.
We then drive the truck back to Mark's house until it can be used for the upcoming event.
First thing we need to do is set up the mats and take out any materials that we need to use. We then...
No.
Oh. We then put the final touches to the setup by taking out chairs for our countless diehard fans and other things like the entrance and CD players.
After that, we just put on our characters' costumes and go over a few spots with our opponent who we're wrestling that day. After that, we put on our character's costume and go over a few spots with our opponent who are wrestling that day.
Go.
As promised earlier in the video, we'll show you... Okay. As promised earlier in the video, we will show you the latest results in a music video entitled HCW...
Go.
As promised earlier in the video, we will show you the results of our latest event in a music video entitled HCW Blade.
We called this event Blade in memory of our late friend, Eric Coglin, who wrestled under the name Blade in HCW just a few short years ago. I hope you've enjoyed this video.